In recent weeks, social media in China has been flooded with amateur video clips that caught the attention of many military watchers. In those clips, a dark-colored attack helicopter can be seen flying low, making sharp maneuvers, and going through various trials at a test facility whose exact location is not officially mentioned. Many analysts strongly believe that this helicopter is the Harbin Z-21, a prototype of a new generation attack helicopter being prepared for the Chinese Army. International defense media, such as Army Recognition, see the appearance of the Z-21 in several recordings as a sign that the program has already entered an intensive flight test phase, no longer just a mock-up or computer render. In other words, we are watching a project that is moving into a more mature stage, getting ready for mass production and eventually frontline deployment. Put simply, China is now seriously testing a heavy attack helicopter that is expected to become one of the main pillars of its ground combat power in the future. For most people, a simple question will appear: what exactly is the Z-21 and why do so many people call it the Chinese Apache? To keep it simple, the Z-21 can be classified as a heavy attack helicopter. This type of helicopter is not built to carry troops or cargo, but is designed specifically to fight on the front line, hunting tanks, armored vehicles, artillery systems, and enemy defensive positions. In the United States, that role belongs to the AH-64 Apache. In China, that role is slowly being prepared for the Z-21. Before the Z-21, China was already operating the Z-10 attack helicopter. The Z-10 often appears in military drills and parades, and for years has been one of the symbols of the Chinese Army's air power. However, in terms of capability, the Z-10 is more suitable to be called a medium attack helicopter. Its engine power, weapon load, and protection are still below heavy attack helicopters like the Apache. At this point, the PLA realized it needed a stronger platform to face modern warfare scenarios that are far more intense and complex. This is where the Z-21 comes in as the answer. Based on various open source analysis, the Z-21 is developed using the Harbin Z-20 transport helicopter as its base. A helicopter often nicknamed Copy Hawk because its shape looks similar to the UH-80 Black Hawk. But the mission is completely different. The Z-20 focuses on transporting troops and equipment, while the Z-21 is designed from the start as a pure combat machine. Its fuselage is reworked, the cockpit is arranged in a tandem two-seat layout, and small stub wings are added on the sides to carry missiles and rockets. Using the Z-20 as a base platform is actually a very logical decision. The Z-20 already uses indigenous turboshaft engine with fairly high power. By using the same engine or an upgraded version, the Z-21 gains enough power to carry more weapons, extra fuel, and additional armor plating around the cockpit and other critical areas. With this configuration, the helicopter is not only able to deliver powerful strikes, but also has a better chance of surviving ground fire. From a logistics point of view, this approach also brings big advantages. Sharing many components and systems with the Z-20 simplifies the spare part supply chain. Technicians don't have to learn too many completely different types, and air crews can adapt faster because the basic systems are already familiar. In short, the PLA can save time, money, and effort in both training and maintenance. Visually, the Z-21 reminds many observers of the AH-64 Apache. It has a long nose section, a tandem cockpit, small wings on the sides, and what appears to be a radar module planned for the top of the rotor mast. This is why a lot of analysts have nicknamed the Z-21 the Chinese Apache. However, that nickname is more about its class and strategic role than an accusation that it is a direct copy. Similar designs appear because many countries face similar battlefield demands. They need helicopters that are agile, powerful, and capable of carrying a large amount of weapons. The Z-21 is also linked to the use of two indigenous turboshaft engines that are more powerful than those used on the Z-10. Because of that, the helicopter is expected to have a higher cruising speed, better performance at higher altitudes, and enough power to operate effectively in mountainous regions. For China, this matters a lot because they must be ready for a potential conflict in high altitude areas such as the border with India and the Tibet and Paito, not just in lowlands and coastal zones. If a helicopter can perform well in thick mountain air, military operations in Western China become much more flexible and dangerous for any opponent. On its stub wings, the Z-21 is designed to carry a wide mix of weapons. These can include modern anti-tank guided missiles, guided rockets, unguided rockets, and short-range air-to-air missiles to counter airborne threats. With such a loadout, a single Z-21 can serve as a small flying arsenal, able to strike several different types of targets in a single sortie. For ground troops, having a helicopter like this overhead can be a deciding factor when facing enemy tank formations and armored vehicles. One of the features that receives a lot of attention is the possible installation of a millimeter wave radar on top of the rotor, similar to the donut radar on the Apache Longbow. Simply put, this radar acts as an extra eye that can scan for vehicles and enemy positions, even in poor weather or at longer ranges. Combined with fire-and-forget missiles, the pilot can lock onto a target, fire, and then quickly retreat behind hills or tree lines. Using the hit-and-hide tactic greatly increases the helicopter's chances of surviving enemy return fire. In terms of survivability, the Z-21 also appears to be designed quite seriously. The exhaust outlets are angled upward, which is believed to help reduce the heat signature, making it harder for heat-seeking missiles to get a lock. The cockpit is expected to be protected by armor plating, and self-protection systems such as jammers, flares, and chaff can help confuse both enemy radar and incoming missiles. The main idea is clear. The PLA not only wants a lethal helicopter, but also wants to give its pilots a good chance of coming home alive. If we compare it directly with the Z-10, the Z-21 can be seen as a step up in class. The Z-10 still has an important role as a lighter and more agile medium attack helicopter, but the Z-21 offers a different package. Heavier weapon loads, longer endurance in the air, and the ability to operate in harsher environments. Most likely, both helicopters will be used side by side, complementing each other in different types of missions. Strategically, the rise of the Z-21 cannot be separated from the broader map of tensions around China. Areas like the Taiwan Strait, the South China Sea, and the border with India are regions constantly watched by the world because they often become flashpoints for military friction. A heavy attack helicopter like the Z-21 can be used to smash frontline defenses before ground forces move forward. It can also work together with drones, long-range artillery, and missiles to create layered strikes that are very difficult to resist. At the same time, the Z-21 sends a clear political message. For many years, heavy attack helicopters such as the Apache have been seen as symbols of Western military technological superiority. By pushing the Z-21 into an intensive flight test phase, China is signaling that it can now play in the same league when it comes to modern attack helicopter technology. This is not only about adding a new weapon, but also about shaping an image as the major power that does not intend to fall behind. Still, it is important to remember that the Z-21 is currently a prototype and remains in the testing phase. There has been no official announcement on how many units will be built, when exactly it will enter service, or which frontline units will receive it first. Much of what we know so far comes from photos, videos, and defense media analysis trying to read patterns from those test flights. In other words, its final design and specifications may still change before it is widely deployed. However, judging from the repeated pattern of appearances on social media, coverage in international defense outlets, and reports of trials in high-altitude regions, it is very unlikely that the Z-21 is just a temporary project. This helicopter seems to be prepared as a long-term component of the Chinese Army's combat power. When the Z-21 eventually enters service, it will operate inside a new ecosystem. Armed drones, precision missiles, long-range artillery, and modern surveillance networks. The battlefield in Asia will feel very different compared to one or two decades ago. For countries around China, both in East Asia and in Southeast Asia, the arrival of the Z-21 is a reminder that the race in military technology is ongoing and relentless. Every new weapon system that enters service is not just a number in a budget document, but a real factor that must be considered in exercises, doctrine, and defense planning. Any country that falls behind in technology and modern military thinking will face serious risks if ever conflict breaks out. In the end, the Harbin Z-21 is more than just another helicopter flying in China's skies. It reflects how modern warfare is becoming more complex, faster, and heavily dependent on technology.